Welcome to the fifth week of this course. This series of videos will cover communication, internal microgrid control, and ancillary services that can be provided to the upstream network. In this video, we will discuss the different communication area networks. Additionally, we will have a quick look at the applicable communication standards that can be used in microgrids. The communication layer is in charge of providing all the information regarding the status of the physical layer to the control and protection layer. This allows this control and protection layer, also called the intelligence layer, to properly carry out its functions. The proper choice of the communication network for each electrical grid depends mainly on its size. For example, while the wide area network is used for very large electrical grids, the home area network is used for the smaller grids. So let's define the different communication areas. The wide area network, as mentioned, handles long-distance data transmission in large grids. This high-bandwidth network allows two-way communication for monitoring and automation purposes. The field area network acts as a connection point between the customer and the secondary substation. The near area network, or near me area network, supports the home energy management system and consists of a cluster of small body area networks. Finally, the local area network operates on the smallest grids. The body area networks, industrial area networks, and home area networks are all local area networks. Domestic consumers are in home area networks, while industries are in industrial area networks. The body area networks that we mentioned earlier combine several home area networks, each belonging to a different home or apartment. As we just mentioned, the lowest levels of communication architecture are the body area network, industrial area network, and home area network. The body area network does two things. First, it manages the communication inside each building, which can be considered a nanogrid. It also collects the production of the renewable energy sources within a building and the consumption of each apartment, which can be considered a picogrid. The home area network is responsible for gathering the consumption data and controlling smart appliances within each apartment. This task is usually done by a home energy management system and home automation systems. This home energy management system includes graphical user interfaces, where the consumer can track their consumption, and also includes supervisory control and data acquisition systems to save information. In these systems, the most used protocol are Wi-Fi, Humplug, DSL, Zigbee, Zigbee Smart Energy, and others. Zigbee Smart Energy is based on the standard IEEE 802.15.4, but in order to support the most widespread protocol, TCP/IP, they include the IP protocol in the network layer. At an upper layer, the near me area network could be used for the communication inside a microgrid. At distribution level, a field area network can be found, which is responsible of the communication between the substations and the microgrid. These areas hold standards for substation and automation, such as the IEC 61850. Before the consumption and production data of each nanogrid is sent to the distribution system operator, each microgrid has a near-me area network with a central data hub in charge of collecting the data packets and storing them. Nowadays, the communication drivers use a Wi-Fi for buildings, PLC, DSL, cellular communications, or fiber. Finally, energy management systems have the goal of optimizing the energy use, collecting power consumption and power generation data of different microgrids. Data about the consumption of buildings and industries in each microgrid are transferred to the gateway from the smart meters, and then the gateway sends the messages to the wide area network. In the wide area network, there will be a central controller. This could be the distribution system operator or other operators sending parameters to the microgrid operator. The current communications drivers used in these networks are usually 3G or 4G, cellular communications, WiMAX or optical fiber, and satellite. Several standards are available and applicable to microgrids for different purposes. We're going to mention a few of them. IEEE 1547 provides criteria and requirements for interconnection between distributed energy resources and the main grid. IEEE C 37.95 describes the protective relaying of utility consumer interconnections. IEC 61000 is about general conditions or rules necessary for achieving safety function and integrity requirements related to electromagnetic compatibility. IEEE 37.188 is the IEEE standard for synchrophasors in power systems. Finally, EN50160 describes the voltage characteristics of the electricity supplied by public distribution networks. In particular, EN50160 is an important standard for voltage characteristics. It provides information on power quality, frequency, and voltage variations, such as voltage sag and swell, unbalanced voltage, and current flows and harmonics in microgrids. So let's sum up what we have seen today. First, we briefly described the different area networks and their application in microgrid context. In a nutshell, the wide area network communicates with the power grid. The field area network allows information exchange between microgrids. The near-me area network is suitable for nanogrids, and the industry area network for industries. At the household level, the communication infrastructure consists of the building and home area networks. Today, we also mentioned that different protocols are used for communication and data exchange. At the end of the video, we discussed that international standards can be applied to microgrids in order to monitor and control the correct functioning of all components, especially at the communication layer.